Hi y'all, what's going on? This is a new series we were making. It's called Vintage Playgrounds, okay? It's where we touch, mess, and tinker with cars, okay? So we're gonna talk about what we're gonna mess with the car. We're gonna talk about what we're taking out, what we're doing. We are currently draining the coolant from the car. I'm pretty sure it's pretty loud. We have my man's Alex Tao right here.
What's up, guys?
Alex Tao 17 going on right here.
So we're gonna take off the radiator just so we have room to take out the motor out, and then after that I'm gonna take out the hose that's connected to the radiator all the way through the block. It should be very simple.
Alright, so we were able to take off the two rims. However, the left side of the driver's side, the wheel side is kind of bent. It's kind of like this. It gave us a hard time trying to remove that. But then able to take off both sides, watch this transition though. So Alex was able to take off the radiator,
kind of look around, like place that I need to take off. I need to take off the AC and the climb spring onto the side because this car do still have AC not, and it do still have climb spring. So that's probably the first step I'm gonna do now. Take out the AC and the climb spring.
All right, so as you can see, we're both pretty tired, but we just took off the power steering. Alex is taking off the coolant hose, the back coolant hose. After that, we'll be pretty much, not done, but halfway there. All the big stuff will be kind of out the way, and then we'll start working on the mounts and stuff.
Yeah.
All right, we got another board that's pulled up. I mean, it's Andy right there. All right, so we got Chance.
Just got done. Well, I'm not done yet, but still painting.
Still painting.
Painting the house?
Yeah.
Got Andy.
All right, so me and Sal, we're like halfway there. At the moment now, we are gonna take off the headers. And so Sal's gonna do the headers. I'm gonna be doing the axle. What we did was we took off the shift cable. We took off the power steering, the radiator, the battery, just so we can have more room. Now I'm going to be doing axle and take off the T-bracket bolt just so it can be loose.
It is getting kind of late now, but we're going to try to do as much as we can. It is getting kind of cold too. We already took out most of the stuff around the engine. Alex is trying to take out the other side axle, driver side axle. But yeah, let's get it. Taking out the subframe.
Alright, so basically me and Sal, we did a lot. We took off subframe, axle, with the half shaft. We unbolted the headers. So we took off the cable, the shift cable off, alternator, AC out. Now me and Sal, we're gonna put the engine hoist, put it on, and then we're gonna probably take out the whole motor out. So yeah, wait for that.
Alright, so as you can see, the engine is out. The whole engine's out, plus the transmission. One thing to take note when you're taking out the engine to get afterwards, if you haven't gotten it already, is mounts. You realize something, hold on. This mount is on the transmission side, and it's completely fucked up. So if you're ever taking it out and you're gonna get something, I recommend mounts if you haven't already. Now this is a perfect time to start buying all the hoses you need, honestly. Alright, so before this clip ends, we got the H23, the H22. Most likely in the next clip, we're gonna move all of this stuff. Most of it, some of it is gonna be deleted, and we're gonna put onto here. And yes, you will see that in the next clip, alright? Alright y'all, so it's the next clip. removing the stuff from the H22A4 now. We're gonna remove the harness, and we're gonna reuse the intake manifold, and we're basically just gonna try to get everything from the old engine to the new engine. Pretty straightforward. Alright guys, as you can see, the H22, its intake manifold is now off. We were able to take out everything in the back, the harness, the intake manifold, and now everything else is going to go onto the H23 here. As you can see, this is the transmission. It is on here. We're going to take out the transmission tomorrow. We are in the long run right now. We are currently waiting for mounts to come in, but then those mounts are not coming in. They are in North Dakota, and they said it will arrive tomorrow, and pretty dirty in the back here, but we're able to put everything on, almost everything onto the H23, and we will see you in the next clip. Y'all ready for this? Transmission's off the H22. I take off the pressure plate and clutch. I still have the flywheel to take off. But yeah, transmission's off. We're gonna put it on to the H23 probably today. And then wait for my motor mounts. And then wait for my ECU to be chipped. Once those are done, we were able to move on to the next step, which is putting it back into the car. But we're all waiting for parts to come in. And I bought this ECU that was already chipped, and it was my fault that I didn't look at it before I gave it to or before I bought it, so that's a little stub in the toe there, you know. But yeah, we're gonna get it going right now. I got a K&N oil filter. We're gonna install this on right now. Let's see what it is. Ooh, very nice, very nice. All right, so pretty simple, just turn this. Oh, this is on pretty tight. Make sure to have something under the engine to clean up. Get some clean oil and rub the ring and the inside. I'm using the last, oh shit, the last bit of my oil. Put it in until it's hand tightened. Alright, it's pretty tight. Hands snug for sure. Alright, so we got some silicone here. Previous person who did it, they just applied a bunch of silicone right here, as you can see. I don't know if you can see, but there's like this little groove. But apply to the groove and see. Hopefully, it goes in.
So right now we're taking out the tensioner. So this is the OEM. So the reason why we're swapping it is because we want it to last us longer. So we bought the aftermarket. We bought the 1321, which it can do is you can adjust the height of this, which the stock one you can't. It just automatic just go on and then your tension just go tight. But this we can play with our adjustment. So this is the OEM one. You can see a big old difference on it too, which the aftermarket is way smaller. All you gotta do is just put through here, put through there. Make sure it's on good. Tying both. So right now I'm tying the tension right now. There you go. That's how you install the tensioner. Aftermarket tensioner on the A series.
Am I in the frame? Barely. All right, y'all. So So we were able to install the pulley, basically install all of the balance shaft eliminator, the tensioner, and then now we're gonna put in the transmission. We just put on the flywheel, and then now we're gonna do the clutch, push plate, and transmission.
So me and Sal, we just got almost everything completed on the long block. So what we did so far was we put the clutch, tranny, push plate, everything on, put the manifold, we make sure everything was tight and complete. And now we're just waiting for the motor mount for the car.
All right, y'all. So as you can see, the engine is not here anymore. As you can see, we didn't film any of those scenes of us putting the engine into the bay. We didn't record any of those because the camera actually died and I forgot to charge the battery. So that was a good amount of content that I missed. I am installing the AC compressor, the power steering pump, and the alternator. I already installed some of those, but I'm tying them. It was kind of difficult, but let me show you around.
Hey, yeah, I should be about to be done already. Now, I'm gonna try to get work on the cable. The cable's right there. I feel like we should have put it down first, but anything, I'm gonna try to push that cable in through the bottom of the manifold. Alright, so basically, at the moment now, Sal right now is getting the driver's side all like wiring and like hoses done right now. And I'm about to do the passenger side, plug in all the little stuff that we need to plug in right now. After we're done with the top, we're probably gonna go on the bottom, get the T-bracket bolt up, get the axle in, put the subframe in after. And then I think if anything, we're gonna do subframe last. We should be good to start up. Let's get started. Alright, so right now I'm putting on the dizzy right now. Later, so I'm gonna go get some spark plug. So I'm just gonna put the dizzy on, and then after that we'll get to the bottom, about to do axle and then put the subframe on.
We got Dale came in.
What's up, Brian? I haven't been here. This is my first day here.
Original man.
First day on the job.
First day on the job.
They fired me and they hired me again.
That'd be a little bit.
Fire me, guy, and do shit last time in Chinese one.
Alright, y'all, so the last clip you saw was Alex standing right here messing with the distributor. It's been about a month. We did have some problems. We knew it was gonna happen, but we totally forgot about it. Because I didn't swap over the crank sensor or oil pump, whatever, I had to get a OBD1 distributor. I bought this from AutoZone or O'Reilly. This is a Rewire OBD2 to OBD1 distributor. All right, so OBD1 distributor, Rewire OBD2 to OBD1 harness. It connects all the way down to the crank sensor, and then that's it. And I was able to get the car started. The ECU I'm running is a stock Prelude ECU. I'm still getting a OBD1 ECU chipped right now, but the car feels amazing. Torque is there for sure. Car looks nice with the blue top. But yeah, that was the last thing that we needed to do. We just needed to change this distributor, get the harness, and that was it. So if you like this video and it inspires you to JDM swap your car or swap any engine to your Prelude, go ahead and do it, because it was totally worth it. Now I'm not shooting out blue smoke every time I drive because my H22A4 was smoking bad. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the next videos, and see you guys later.